Church for our weekly music and midday concert. My name is Mike McMahon, I'm the Artistic Director, and it's a pleasure to welcome all of you today, especially those of you who may be visiting or are here for the first time. This is a magnificent building for worship, gathering, and for music to the instruments just sound amazing in this wonderful church. So welcome to our today's concert. It's a little different.
Tatyana, who is a native of Kyiv, Ukraine, would like to open today's recital with the Ukrainian national
Although she once declared, women are not born
She nonetheless created 24 works in her 20s and 30s, including the set of three romances.
Thank you.
Our next two pieces are by Florence Price and German Tatyana. Born in Arkansas, Florence Price started composing as a child and later studied piano and organ at the New England Conservatory. To escape racial tensions in the South, she moved to Chicago, and in 1933, she became the first Black woman to have a symphony performed by a major orchestra, in this case, the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. Price's music combines Western European romanticism with elements of spirituals, blues, and jazz. Was the only woman in the group of eminent French composers known as musiques. She pursued her musical career against the wishes of her father, and, as the story goes, she changed her surname from Taillefesse to Taillefer to Spike. Taillefer believed that a composition must be lacking in artistry. Listener could not identify a composer's style from the first three bars. Her masseuse, or cradle song, gives the listener a sense of her distinctive voice, characterized by clarity, spontaneity, and charm.
Thank you.
composed for a Soviet-era film, is so well known throughout Ukraine that most people believe it is needed folk music. Tatyana and I dedicate our performance of this work to the people of Ukraine and all who are supporting and helping them through this terrible time. American composer Winifred Walker, who was born in 1947, considers her work to be rooted in New England. For decades, she lived on a dairy farm in Vermont. She composed fantasy etudes for a mother-daughter piano-violin duo. The work consists of five short movements, alternating between invigorating and poignant. And to me, the music feels quintessentially American. The last movement, strolling on Frederick Street, is jaunty opera music composed while the opera was living in the Haight-Ashbury neighborhood of San Francisco. Thank you.
Thank you.